from here. So basically, that we were talking about the grammar rules and all, this is the extension to that. So one more rule while you are writing, you know, you're following the technical writing stuff. One thing that you need to remember is that you have to remove the variants. Now, what do we understand by variance? Any idea? What is the literal meaning of this word, variance? Huh, the difference. Okay, yes, yes. So, variance means the difference, right? Now, you know, when we are talking about a technical writing, the write-up that we have, we should have a minimum inconsistency. That means we should maintain the consistency all over the document in terms of formatting, in terms of the style, in terms of the font size. So everything should be consistent. That, I mean, only the then we can say that, you know, our write-up is zero variant. Okay. So let's see what it is. So when we say what is variance, it means it is the dissimilarity of different objects within the same type. So if we have different kinds of objects, then it becomes variant. So suppose you have 10 marbles, each of varying size and color, then we have the variance is very high. And I mean, and if they are all same, then we can say it has zero variance, right? Now, why is it bad for technical writing? Any idea, people, why the variance would be bad when we are writing? Suppose we have written some article and we have all sorts of say, shapes and sizes and, you know, the styles. So what is the harm in that? Why do we need to have a similarity there? Yes. So sometimes what will happen, the end user would find it very difficult. Also, it, you know, the presentability is lost. So if you do not follow that consistency in terms of size and in terms of the style, the layout, the design, it becomes very difficult and cumbersome for the end user to understand that. So that's why, see, it's written that if all your content differs, then it is high variance and we should not allow that. So you should maintain the layout, the design, and then only you can call it as a zero variant. So if you have heading one as 12 size, so all over, you know, if you have the entire book of 100 pages everywhere, the heading size should be same, right? So that's how you can maintain, you can eliminate the variance. Now, consistency is welcome in documentation and technical documents. Variety is good in creative writing, not when you are writing for the technical stuff. So that's why we need to eliminate it. Now, how do we eliminate it? First thing that we can do is we can write the whole document in the same way such that everywhere the references are the same. So first of all, what we can do is that whatever, you know, we can have a standard style guide and we follow that. So that will help us to eliminate all those differences that are there. And if you are in you know, so they have given you an example. Suppose you are making a manual for an airplane, okay? Now, somewhere you use the word propellers, okay? So, and then in, you know, somewhere after that, when you are talking about the manual, you talked about, you replaced that propellers with blade, with the term blade. Now, the variance is high because for the same term, we are using different words, right? So, what will happen? What is the harm in that? So, first of all, product manuals, user manuals, these are very difficult to understand in first go because there are, you know, a set of steps that the person has to follow. Now, on the top of it, if you use different terminologies, then it will definitely create confusion in the minds of the readers. So, that's why we should make sure that whatever term we want to use, it is all over the document. Now, it says, it says, so if you want to keep consistency, just refer to the fan as a fan. So if there is a term, a simple term that you can use, use that only. Don't complicate the things and keep the consistency because we are writing to educate the people, not to excite or entertain them. So that's why our major objective should be to explain them. So zero variance in the document, that means terms, words, phrases, layouts, designs, fonts, color palette, should not vary. So whatever design and style that we are following, it should be followed throughout. Creativity in technical writing is not good. We are again and again talking about this. All text should be clear and without any creativity. Maximum consistency, minimum variance. So what happens is sometimes we feel that, you know, if we will put different designs, different bullet points, you know, somewhere let's put the one style of bullet points, the other, why not? Because in MS Word, there are so many options available. So why not do that? But that is not allowed in technical documents. Technical documents are made for educating the people so that your consistency is maintained in terms of bullet points, in terms of all the layouts and designs. So we will not experiment there. Like, for example, in the first abstract, you are writing all blue text, and then coming to the introduction, you are writing the background as yellow, and then so all that creativity is not required in technical documents. So right to educate, explain, show, eliminate errors, and not for excitement and fun. That's why we follow this. Okay, now the next point that we have is the active voice and passive. We have already talked about it, I think. We have written some sentences in active, and then we tried it for the passive, right? So what happens is, when you try to make the passive voice sentences, the complication increases, and also the number of words increases. So that's why, to avoid it, let's keep it active voice and try to use them as. Okay, so that's how. So see, they have also given you some examples here, so that you can use them and not use the passive voice. Okay, all right. So active voice mostly uses the present tense. Passive would use the past tense. Here the subject will act upon the verb. Here in the passive, the order changes. Then we have strong, direct, and clear tone. So in active voice, it's a strong and direct sentence, which is a requirement of a technical document. Whereas in passive voice, normally the introduction to ing forms, like you will have to use being used, or you know, something like that. So again, complications would be there in terms of sentences. So like, for example, they have said monkeys adore bananas. There are three words, simple sentence, straightforward. Now we are changing it. It becomes bananas are adored by monkeys. So why to complicate it? And the number of words have also increased. Right. So to avoid that, I'll try to use active voice. Okay. So far, everything clear? Any questions? All right. Now let's talk about the other rule that we have. It says you should eliminate anthropomorphism. Any idea what is this term? What do we understand by this term? It's a long term, difficult to pronounce even. What is the meaning of it? If anyone has been into literature or something. Any idea? So actually, anthropomorphism talks about the human emotions, the traits. So normally, whatever fairy tales and the you know, the story books that you would have heard, or you have heard, so that it looks as if that turtle or the tortoise was not an animal but a human being. So those human traits used as emotions and all that is not allowed in technical write-up. So we eliminate that kind of terms or that kind of references. Okay, so that's what it says. It says at anthropomorphism is the attribution of human traits, of emotions, intentions to non-human entities. So whosoever is the, it's not a human being, but then we portray it as if it is, right? So normally you will find it in storybooks, a lot of them. So technical writing is supposed to be direct and plain as possible. So we avoid this. We focus on author or writer as for the subject in the sentence. So we have to be focused, related to the topic, and our write-up revolve around the subject and the goal that we have, right? So we have to be careful there. So that is what we need to eliminate here. Then the second thing that we need to eliminate is the dangling participles. Remember, we have done this a bit in the last unit as well. What are dangling participles, people? What happens in this if we have dangling participles there in the sentence? Okay, let's go through this example. So it says, walking through the courtyard, the fire alarm was going off. Is this sentence correct? Do you think the sentence is correct, people? It's incorrect. So it seems as if the fire alarm is walking, right? So the subject is being, the sentence is becoming ambiguous. We are not able to understand who is the subject here. So how do I correct this? Try to correct the sentence, people. Tell me, how do I correct the sentence? Okay, so you say walking through the courtyard, and then we put a comma and the fire alarm was going off. I can say while I was walking through the courtyard, the fire alarm was going off. I can even say while walking through the courtyard, the fire alarm went off. So avoiding the ing usage. So that's how we can avoid the dangling participle. So basically, dangling participles means when your order is disturbed or your you know subject is being confused in the sentence. So there it creates this dangling participle problem. So we need to avoid this. We need to write direct sentences. Avoid using long sentences. Otherwise, in technical writing, if there will be ambiguity, people would not understand. And it can create havoc because, you know, in the product manual, for example, you are trying to present some process. Now, if the sentence is not clear, people would not understand that what needs to be done and, you know, which apparatus has to be taken. And maybe there is some problem of a clear sentence. So that's why we need to be specific. Now, let's see the other rule that we have is about bracketing. Remember, we talked about this, that if we have a new term, a new acronym, what is the rule for the new acronym? So for the very first time when it is coming in your document, you write the full form and in the bracket maybe. So you can either write the abbreviated form outside and the full form in the bracket or vice versa. Right. So you first, on the first instance, you have to explain it. And then going forward, you can use the abbreviation. Normally, we do it as putting abbreviation outside and putting the full form inside. Right. But again, it depends upon the style guide given to you by your client. So some clients give you the style guide for the abbreviation as well. So in that case, you can do as the client is asking. Otherwise, we normally prefer to write the acronym and then in the bracket to explain that. Because going forward, you will anyways be using that acronym, right? So that's why we write it outside the bracket and the full form in the bracket. Okay. All right. So see, they have given the example, technical writing, functional specification, cascading style sheet, all that. All right. Now, we also have to be very careful in using the punctuations. We have already talked about all the rules, comma, full stop, colon, semicolon, everything we have gone through. So all that has to be proper, right, in the sentences so that there is no confusion. Okay. Also about the brackets, we need to be careful. Okay, so all this needs to be taken care. Now, also you should avoid, using multiple nouns in the sentence. Now, again, it can create ambiguity. Okay, so when it has more than one noun, the technical term for it is a noun train. So it creates a tail of so many nouns, and those nouns can create a cluster, right? And if that is there, then it is very difficult for the readers to understand. Right, so that's why we should avoid doing that. Okay, so this was all about your grammar portion.